Life story of Saint Catherine of Alexandria. Saint Catherine was a devout noble woman or princess who was so well educated in the liberal arts that by the age of 18 she surpassed most learned men. Catherine reportedly had a vision in which she married Jesus Christ. According to one account, he appeared as an infant and placed a ring on her finger. This mystical marriage also foreshadowed Catherine's participation in the sufferings of her spouse. Around the year 305, when the Emperor Maximinus began persecuting Christians, Catherine courageously upbraided him. Marveling at her boldness, Maximinus imprisoned her and summoned 50 philosophers to debate her. Instead of being overwhelmed, Catherine won many of them over to Christ, so much so that they vowed to die a martyr's death. The furious Maximinus ordered the imprisonment of Catherine of Alexandria. During her imprisonment, she was scourged so brutally that her whole body bled frequently with streams of blood flowing. However, she didn't show any signs of fear or suffering. She was not given food so that she would starve to death. According to Orthodox churches, angels from heaven would come to feed her and heal her wounds. It is also said that Jesus visited her as well. Catherine of Alexandria was visited by hundreds of people during her imprisonment, including Maximinus's wife, Valeria Maximinus, who converted to Christianity. After various attempts to bribe and intimidate her failed, the emperor sentenced Catherine to die on a wheel spiked with sharp knives. The wheel, however, was struck by lightning and exploded the shrapnel, killing several onlookers. This miracle inspired more conversions, but it did not quell the emperor's wrath, who ordered Catherine to be beheaded. After she died, angels transported the saint's remains to Mount Sinai. The holy influence. Because of the manner of her martyrdom, Saint Catherine is invoked against head ailments such as headache, migraine, and brain tumors. And because of her virginal marriage to Christ, she is called upon as a protector of purity, a matchmaker for unwed girls, and a patroness of childcare and nurses. Moreover, Saint Catherine is credited with helping others to become saints. Saint Gertrude the Great is said to have had a special attraction to Saint Catherine from her infancy. When Gertrude asked how great were the saint's merits, our Lord showed her a vision of Saint Catherine seated on a throne so lofty and so magnificent that it seemed her glory was sufficient to have filled the courts of heaven. Had she been its sole queen, while from her crown a marvelous brightness was reflected on her devout clients. Saint Catherine also appeared along with Our Lady to Blessed Reginald of Orleans and to Saint Dominic, which is why she is one of the Dominicans' special patronesses. For 7 years, Saint Joan of Arc was guided by several heavenly voices that she called her counsel. Among those that visited her, the Maid of Orleans recognized Saint Catherine of Alexandria, Saint Margaret of Antioch, and Saint Michael the Archangel. It was probably these voices that told her to look for an ancient sword buried behind the altar of a chapel. The feast of Saint Catherine of Alexandria is celebrated on November 25th. The reflection from this life story. The pursuit of God's wisdom may not lead to riches or earthly honors. In Catherine's case, this pursuit contributed to her martyrdom. She was not, however, foolish in preferring to die for Jesus rather than live only by denying him. All the rewards that her tormentors offered her would rust, lose their beauty, or in some other way become a poor exchange for Catherine's honesty and integrity in following Jesus Christ. We conclude, we pray that may we be blessed with that honesty and integrity to follow our Lord and our Savior. Amen. Thank you for watching. Wishing you all a beautiful day. beautiful day. Amen.